Page 96, Lord, lead me out.
Yeah. paid 94.
Yeah, we would.
Before we get saying, I want to thank God Ben's with us more time. He got me in the house more time. I want to just bend my hand, and she's still kind of weather, we've been for back hurting, windy. But I thank God is out of here.
Bless him, Lord.
You know, I love the Lord so much that sometimes the devil gets on me and.
Bless him, Lord.
You know, I sat at home today and.
Bless him, Lord.
Had a little pity party for myself. The devil got on my back about something, but you know. I leave it with him.
Bless him, Lord.
He'll take care of it.
Bless him, Lord.
You know, I just want to thank him for getting me here tonight. I hope we have a good service. I hope we see somebody get saved.
Bless him, Lord.
It'll be worth it all.
Bless him, Lord.
But God leaves you something to do, you better do it.
Bless him, Lord.
It's your blessing.
Yes.
He seen his son die for us.
God sent his son. They call him Jesus. He came to love. He died for me. He
Nothing else, nothing less, Travis.
Right.
Amen. So it's a good place to be tonight, certainly is. Amen. Come carrying good news tonight. I heard three got saved today in different places, and I'll thank the Lord for that.
Amen.
I'm glad tonight to know he's still in the saving business. Amen. He certainly is. I'm glad tonight he'll turn no one away tonight, as long as they come with a broken heart and contrite spirit tonight. And he would no wise cast anyone out tonight. And as they got to tell me about the people today being saved, I got to sitting there tonight thinking about mine. Amen. I'll tell you tonight, it's a wonderful thing to be saved tonight. It certainly is. I hope we've come in our hearts and our minds centered upon him tonight. Amen. Just be willing to let the Lord use you tonight, and he'll bless you for that. He certainly will tonight. So it's a good place for me to be tonight. I appreciate everybody coming and being with us tonight. And the main one tonight, we've just got to have the Lord. We've got to have his spirit to do anything. And if we don't have him, why, we might as well dismiss and go to the house.
Amen.
We've got to have his spirit and his power tonight. And I tell you, boy, I hope the dirt that the Lord just blesses you real good.
Amen.
Amen. I really do. I hope the Lord just gets a hold of him real good.
Amen.
Comes by and uses him. That's my heart's desire.
Amen.
It certainly is. And not only him, but each and every one of you.
Amen.
It just uplifted me today. And finally, I hung up. Let me do it. Just give me a hit run again. More good news. Amen. So tonight I'm glad to just pass that on.
Amen.
To you, the Lord is still saving us. Wants to be saved.
Right.
I'm glad I was saved. Amen. I'm glad that fear is gone.
Amen.
I know what it felt like to have that fear.
Amen.
Lost and dying. Amen. Without hope. Living in the darkness of night. Amen. I'm glad I come to the marvelous light of God.
Amen.
Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord for Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody got something on your heart? Tell it, girl.
Bless
you, Paul. God bless your heart.
Amen.
There's another, and they're glad they're saved.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Mario, I thank God for their privilege to be in his house. Thank God I know what I'm saying.
Amen.
Thank God for the service tomorrow, and I look for another good one tonight.
Yes, amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I'd like for y'all to remember we lost a nephew last week.
Yeah.
That family's in need greatly, and on the way to church tonight, the youngest brother called me, asked me if I was coming to church, and I told him, yeah. He said, have church pray for him.
Yeah.
Please remember the whole family.
Amen. 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 It's your heart. You remember this or please.
Remember Whitney, of course. I know she's still in the hospital. And also remember Valerie. She's
got no surgery. Amen. Do remember Lisa. Amen. If you'll be with us tomorrow.
That's right. That's right.
Amen. But we're here tonight.
That's right.
Amen.
I shall remember my grandfather. He had a heart attack last week, and I was able to call him today on the way here, and he actually answered the phone, which was great. I tell you, I had to cry for him. I know where he's going. I shall remember him in y'all's prayers.
Amen. God bless your heart, John.
And ask y'all to continue to pray for our boys
for
prayer. Make it the same drop. We can only do so much as prayer.
True.
Only take them so far.
Yeah.
Not going to see God.
Yeah.
Watch over.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Bless you, Brian. Do you remember these requests?
Yeah. Lord, I want to thank God for his promises tonight.
Yes.
He said for this one, he can save our household.
Yeah.
I'm just holding with that promise.
Amen.
Because I know in this time that it'll happen. I just ask you to remember me now. He felt doing what God had it to.
Yeah, amen. God bless you, Travis.
Not like you. I pray the Lord gets a hold of Derek tonight and just sets him free. Because you know what I say now? The Lord did that for me. And I got to feed on that for a whole week. You know what I think? I want to tell you is I thank you for your prayers.
Amen.
I want to thank God for this church and what it means to me.
Yeah.
Amen.
But I thank you most of all for saving me.
Amen.
Yes, amen. Bless him for me.
Bob Keller, lead us, we pray. Fifth verse, it says,
the we being many are one body in Christ.
Yeah.
And that's all that he's laid on me to read tonight. And
bless him, Lord.
You know, it's been talked about this morning, and I can tell it's kind of quiet tonight. And I got to think about it. I don't know here lately, but we've seemed like we've kind of slacked off on having church. But when we first joined up here in this place of the powerhouse, we were shouting, singing, testifying, everything. Lost being saved. Well, it seems like we've kind of slacked off a little bit. You remember, Marty, about, what, 3 or 4 months ago that Sunday morning, we went to that next level. And I believe it's that same Sunday night that we come out here and we couldn't get a noise out of nobody.
Bless him, Lord.
You know, we got lost here. They're all over the house, and everybody's saying, I want to see a lost saved, I want to see a lost saved. What's that like? It's time to grow up, it's time to be adults, it's time to come in here, leave the world out behind that white door back there, and sit in here ready to serve the Lord tonight. If you want to see a lost saved, we ain't acting like it. We got a job to do tonight, just to see them saved.
Bless him, Lord. Yeah, we do. Bless him, Lord.
Brother Travis, you've been like a brother to me for 5 years, and I promise you right now that I'm going to try my very best to keep myself out of the way of your son being saved. I want to see him saved. I want to see your daughter be saved. I want to see everyone in here be saved. And I will try my very best, but I may fail to come short. Everybody knows. And thanks to me, oh God, that I want to keep ourselves out of the way and come in here and worship and be ready. Those 3 men saved this morning. They got saved in the Spirit. Those churches are doing what they're supposed to be doing.
Yes,
it's time for us to grow up. Yes. Not coming in here and talking and chit-chatting and blah, blah, blah. Come to have church tonight.
Listen,
boy. I got to think about the other day at work. I was sitting there on the machine breaking rock, and I got to thinking it was real hard rock, and it was just powdering up. And finally, after a little while, you're in the right spot, it'll break. And that's what the devil does to us in the churches. He'll sit there and he'll hit on us and hit on us and he'll hit that certain spot and we'll break. And that's what happens. He gets a hold of us and he'll break us. And then when he breaks you, then he's going to turn around and he's going to break you. And he's going to break you. And next thing you know, we got lost and ain't been saved. We got church and ain't been having church anymore. It's time for Hilltop to start having church again. It's time to stop coming in here with all this other stuff. It's time to start having church. I don't see lost saved just as much as anybody else in here does.
Bless him, Lord.
It's time to start. We need to stop with all this other stuff, whatever. We need to have church. We are one body in Christ. You are my brother, Brad. I didn't know you until a few months ago, but I love you. You're my brother in Christ. John, I love you. You're my brother in Christ. We are one body. If you read that couple verses before that, it says we have many members, but not all the same office.
Right.
We might not all have the same job to do.
Right.
And he's telling you to raise your hand.
Amen.
Raise your hand. He's telling you to sing. Sing. He's telling you to preach.
Amen.
Preach.
Amen.
We might all have the same thing to do, but if you're here tonight, you have something to do.
Yes,
you need to ask yourself, am I the one hearing that lost person being saved? Am I the one standing in the way?
Amen.
Am I the one being saved?
Amen.
You know,
bless him, Lord.
There's been times where I've not done what I'm supposed to do in church. And I've let the devil just sit there and hit on me all week until finally he just breaks me.
Yeah.
And he just kills me thinking, well, what if that lost person was looking at me?
Yeah.
What if he was watching me and waiting for me to do something I didn't do? If one of them walk out here tonight and they die in a car wreck or something, are you going to be asking yourself, well, should I have done that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Should I have done this? Yes, sir. If you're here tonight, you, if God's telling you to do something, you better do it. It don't matter what it is. If you need to sing, if you need to preach, if you're running from something, if you need to be saved, who knows, your friend over here might be waiting for you to be saved before they'll come to the Lord themselves. So whatever it is tonight, we need to do it. We got lost and need to be saved. We need to do it, brother. I want that bragging around. I want those bragging around saying, yeah, there's soul saved all over at Hilltop Sunday night.
Come on,
probably jealous if you want to, but I want those bragging around.
Yeah.
I want them to know the Hilltop is a powerhouse.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what we need to be tonight. We need to come in here one mind, one accord, and let's have church.
Bless
him,
Lord.
Bless
your
heart,
Derek.
Bless
the
Lord.
I want to get back on that next level like we was a while back.
Yeah,
you remember?
I
was singing, I was shout, that's testifying. I've been to too many churches where they're powerhouses, and guess what? The devil starts breaking people here and there. The next thing you know, they fell apart. If you don't remember this church right here, this very church that you're sitting in tonight, a few years ago they wouldn't, but I don't know, just a few people on the registry. And now look what it's come to. I mean it better tonight. I mean it. I want every single spot in here filled. I want people in here listening to the word of God, praising the Lord. I want that for us tonight.
Bless you, Lord.
Bless you,
as far as I need to go tonight, come get a song or whatever we need to do, but I'm ready to have church. I didn't come to preach, I've come to have church.
Bless you, Father. Yeah, amen. Bless you, Father.
Whatever you need to do tonight, just do it. I beg of you just to do it. That lost person may be looking at you.
Amen.
Bless you, boy.
Love you, Jordan. Jordan. Amen.
I love you a lot. Appreciate you, buddy.
Love you, boy. Love you, boy.
Love you, boy.
that heaviness off of you that's there. Amen. The Lord's the only one can take that.
That's right. Amen.
He certainly will. Derek already mentioned it in the message. Don't leave here. I should have tonight. Don't leave here in that condition tonight. I should have come. I should have done this. I should have done that. Let's leave it here.
Yeah,
amen. Would you do that? Appreciate Derek tonight.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Appreciate the message.
Bless Father. Amen. Amen. I want to say I thank God for that message.
Amen. Amen.
Thank God for Derek.
Amen. Better not deny that prayer. But it comes in. You turn that away, you turn all hope away.
Yeah, amen.
Amen. You've turned God Himself away.
That's right.
When that spirit begins to come out there, amen, begins to make us straight, set up straight just a little bit. And pay attention.
Yeah, amen. Amen.
Would you come? Lock me up. Bless some more.
Take away the vision of sin from these eyes, and now we see.
Bless the Lord.
You know, you're sitting here lost and undone tonight, and I'm not trying to add anything to the message, but God has put on my heart. You need to understand what Jesus went through for you. I realize that's how I got saved. But as this song says, he felt every bit of that. He was in the flesh. You better believe he felt every bit of that. Every time that hammer hit the nail going in his hands, he felt every strike. Amen. Every time that it drove him to his feet, he felt every single one of them. That's how much he loves you. Amen. He don't want to hurt you. He wants to save you. Amen. From the devil's hell, yet you still want to turn him away. You don't understand. God wants you to understand. I did all this for you, that you can have a way.
Amen.
I had to realize that before I get saved, Marty. I had to realize first I was lost. And that God loved me. That's all it takes. It's not hard. It's very simple. I ask these girls to give their testimonies, these kids, listen to them, didn't know what to do, except just to go and kneel. That's all it takes. Amen. You don't have to be able to say a lot of big words. Amen. You don't have to say a big prayer. When I knelt down at the altar, I didn't know what to say, Marty. Amen. I didn't have a clue. I was a grown man and didn't have a clue. But the Spirit, amen, it talked to me, Father, on my behalf. Amen. The only way I knew to do was to sit there and say, God, it's me. You know what I need. You know what I've been beat up. Here I am. Ask him. That's all it takes. Why did you give him a chance? What would it hurt?
Right.
Amen. Nothing to lose. You had nothing to lose. But everything in the world again.
Amen.
This world's going to pass away. One day after all, it's going to be gone. Ain't doing a message tonight. I hope and pray that you'll find peace, that you'll bow your knees and find salvation before it's too late. Amen. That's all I can hope. That's all I can pray for.
Amen.
Bless you, Russell. God bless your heart.
Now, it's with the word in your heart now.
Brother Marty, I thank God for being here tonight. I thank God for saved.
Bless the
Lord. I was thinking today just about what Brian was talking about, what Jesus went through.
Yeah.
Going up the hill, getting whipped by the whip and everything.
Bless the
Lord. I want to ask the church for you. Now let a little bit of pain every once in a while keep me out.
Bless
the
Lord.
So if he can go through what he went through, I can go through a little bit of pain. So I want to ask you to give me. This one here's been saved, but I got one more grandchild. I want to say, and I want to see her saved. You say, well, forget everybody saved. Well, they're all good. If we get this church strong enough, he can draw them off the street.
That's right.
I was thinking about Monday. I was laying on that table, and they told me to get up. Somebody dropped the ball. The insurance, the doctor, the hospital, somebody dropped the ball. They didn't get to do the heart cath. But that was one of their faults. If I walk in that door and walk back out in the same condition, that's my fault. That's not the church's.
Right.
That's not your house. That's not God's fault.
Bless him, Lord.
There's a lot in the window, a table.
Yeah, come on, girl.
Bright light shine, it shows about home.
morning. I want to thank God for Derek tonight.
Yes.
I'm going to tell you something in my heart. I won't say it.
Bless you, Lord.
I've been here for a long time. Since 2004. My family always been with me.
Yeah.
They've been sick.